Let me put it this way. For me, investing in girls' education is a sort of a closing a circle of life. It's like going back to recognize that, like a tree, when you want to plant a tree, you begin by preparing the soil, you fertilize it, you water, and then you put the tree. You'll continue to water and to care for it. While it's small, there's a different kind of curve. When it gets a little bit, you prune it, etc., but you continue, I mean, to care for this tree and you look after it. This tree will not give you fruits immediately. It will take its time, but the way you care for it, it is the promise of the kind of fruits you are going to get in a certain period of time. While we are talking of this, we are breaking a circle. We are planning and building new generations of women who are not going to be like us, be talking of the kind of limitations and constraints we have grown in. We want even more than memory. I think I'll take the image of Jeff's daughter, maybe starting my granddaughter, that children, girls of today, if we are really committed in changing this, these are the future of you and I, being here or not, in next generations, we'll be talking of women's rights in a completely different level. So this is the commitment we're making here. And we really have to understand there's no meaningful social change without pruning and supporting these children. They are the future of just societies, equal societies, inclusive societies. If we are serious about that, that's the future we're building. They are the investment, and those who are entrepreneurs, they understand the concept of investing. You put resources here, but you'll get them later. So this investment, it's much broader. It's exactly by caring, inclusive, just, and you name it, the societies where a human being, men and women, will look shoulder to shoulder, value each other and respect each other. That's what we are trying to do with girls' education.